Number 8, conflict management. A key interpersonal skill for those working in teams is conflict management, especially for those looking at leadership roles. Conflict in the workplace can reduce productivity and cause negativity. Good conflict management skills include diplomacy, empathy, negotiation, assertiveness, and compromise. Being able to put your views across or defend the views of others in a professional and respectful way is a key skill in the workplace. Number 9, positive attitude. Showing positivity even in difficult situations is important. Be positive from the moment you fill out the application form or write a cover letter through to the interview, your first day at work and beyond. It's a habit, so you need to develop, and it comes over a period of time. Never say anything negative about your current or past employer, even if you feel strongly about it. Employees with a positive attitude are more likely to treat others positively, which creates a more harmonious working environment. Number 10, workplace etiquette. How you come across to others can speak volumes. Learning workplace etiquette is a great way to leave a lasting impression on those you meet. Check your posture. Ensure that you stand straight and make eye contact. Turn towards people when they are speaking and smile genuinely at them. Follow the dress code of the company and make sure that your accessories such as ties, bags, and jewelry are suitable for the workplace. Also ensure that you demonstrate kindness and courtesy and arrive in good time every morning. So which job requires interpersonal skills? Almost all that exist under this shelter, this universe. If you feel you have strong relationship building capabilities combined with effective collaborative skills, there are certain roles that you will be well suited to. Careers that require client management would be an ideal choice. That said, being able to remember the finer details, having the self-confidence to market yourself properly, and respecting workplace etiquette are skills that are valued in many roles, including customer service. Interpersonal skills are particularly important in customer-facing roles. You will be expected to interact with others daily, often in a problem-solving roles. Communicating clearly and active listening are key customer service skills, whether you are speaking with customers in person or through telephone. Empathy, emotional intelligence, and positivity will also help you engage with customers who need help or are unhappy with the product or services. Property or real estate. When working in property or real estate, you must be able to build relationships with clients and partners and be receptive to the requirements of both buyers and sellers. As buying and selling property is a major financial decision, an estate agent or consultant will need strong negotiation skills and communicative abilities to close sales and find the best price for the seller. Medical professional. Although education and the level of skill required to become a qualified medical professional are most important, interpersonal skills feature strongly in the skill set of a doctor, nurse, or consultants. They must be able to communicate and use non-verbal communication to offer reassurance and put patients at ease. Medical professionals must also be able to discuss sensitive issues with their patients, and bedside manner is very important. Financial planner or a broker. A broker helps its clients to secure the best deal on a range of products from mortgages to insurance. Financial product knowledge is key, but communication skills are also high on the list of priorities. As well as working with clients, brokers also need to develop strong relationships with partners such as banks, lenders, and estate agents. Financial planners will assist their clients in areas such as investments, insurance, and planning for retirement. So they must be able to establish a certain degree of trust. Listening is crucial so that they can understand clients' requirements and then recommend suitable products and services. My God, sales. Relationship management is a key element of many sales roles. Done well, it can lead to new and repeat business from recommendations or referred customers. Sales professionals must also be confident when making cold calls and need to use strong negotiation and listening skills to find out the requirements of the client before offering suitable products or services. How to emphasize your interpersonal skills in your resume? Now that you understand what interpersonal skills are and the industries in which they are most useful, you should be able to identify which you possess the most. Once you have, be sure to emphasize them in your application documents and then, if successful, at the interview level as well. Here are a few tips to help you emphasize the right interpersonal skills in your job application. When drafting your resume, look carefully at the job description and profile to see if any specific interpersonal skills are mentioned. See if these match the interpersonal skills you feel you can demonstrate the best and highlight them in your application. Any skills you mention must be relevant to the role you are applying for. Start your resume with a clear and concise skills section that describes your main attributes. This should be followed by a strong career history section. Again, incorporating your interpersonal skills via your professional experience, academic studies, and voluntary work. Back up every interpersonal skills you mention with evidence. Examples: these skills can feel intangible, so the recruiter will need to see evidence of when you demonstrated them and achieved the positive results. In your cover letter, you can expand this further by explaining how you use these skills and the impact that had on the business. Perhaps your strong communication skills secured a sale, or your successful relationship management resulted in excellent customer feedback. If you are invited to an interview, as well as talking about key interpersonal skills and how you have used them in previous employment, ensure you demonstrate them too. Elements such as workplace etiquette, professionalism, and self-confidence all come into play here. Can I learn interpersonal skills? What a good question. Interpersonal skills are so vital for both work and personal relationships that they are worth developing. Remember, everything that you have learned when interacting with people over your lifetime will have given you a good foundation, but there's always room to improve. Here are some tips to help. Decide which areas you need to improve. Maybe you are aware of certain areas that you are weak in, or there are specific requirements for a job you are applying for. It isn't always easy to self-analyze, so don't be afraid to ask those who are close to you for their feedback. Learn from feedback. Consider the relationship you have with your colleagues. Are there ever any conflicts? Have you ever had any feedback from your boss on your interpersonal skills that you could review? Thinking about the feedback you have been given, either directly or indirectly, will help you develop. Look for online training. Once you have identified the areas you need to improve, look for some online courses that will help you learn certain interpersonal and social skills that would be useful in the workplace. Try searching on Coursera or OpenLearn. There are also many books and articles on this topic you could review. Develop your emotional intelligence. Interpersonal skills rely on reading others correctly and having empathy. Good emotional intelligence will help you accept others' differences and understand their point of view. Practice communicating and listening. If you are normally reserved at work, try to put yourself out there and practice your newly learned communication skills. This will give you the confidence to keep improving. I'm sure now we have a better understanding on interpersonal skills, how they are, what they are, where they should be implemented, how much time we can take learning this. I think it is the moment you start and you start getting to know what it takes and practice consciously, you definitely master at one point of time. But remember, interpersonal skills are those important skills which are the basic prerequisite of every job on this earth. So please take them very, very seriously and also believe that interpersonal skills are a collection, a cumulative of the sub-skills, which are primary skills, the basic skills, which honed over a period of time will definitely make you work towards higher order skills. So, here's wishing you all best luck. Thank you.